Hello YouTube and welcome to my third video or tutorial video for Dragon Bones Pro 5.1. Today what I'll be talking about is meshing, object meshing and attaching the, or binding bones to objects or items itself. So what I've got here, I've already actually loaded in image here, which is a paper. I'll be using this paper. I'm not going to use the paper closed anymore because I'm going to it doesn't work so well over a few seconds, 1 second animation. So what I'm doing is I'm just dragging in the paper, which I just created separately, and load it into my Dragon Bones Pro library with import assets command there. Something I would like to mention as well is you can open entire library or of PNG images if you need to, and recently specify your path. If your path is missed, you'll have a big square with a missing text over it, so you can always just relocate it or specify the new path available. So what I've got here on this images here, first of all, is I'm gonna have to create a mesh on this object. Now before I do that, I'm just gonna make sure that I select the correct bone to start with, and that is the Q button there, and I'm gonna create it off my body. So when I rotate my body, my paper rotates as well. So selecting it up, I'm just gonna start a bone here, drag it up the middle, and obviously fix it a bit later as soon as I add all of the specific meshing items. I'm going to select this image here, going to head over to the property panel and select a command there that says convert to mesh. As soon as you launch that, you can go to the mesh editor. Obviously if it's not available, just use the window drop down there and select on your mesh. So from here, we've got a boundary, a square boundary for the image, which is the normal image extents. So what I'm going to do is, once I open my meshing tab, there you'll see there's five commands. It's modify, create, delete, new edge, or reset. Obviously reset takes it all away, and delete just deletes one specific item. What I'm going to do is I'm specify new edge because I don't want the original extents of this image as the boundary. I want the physical image as the boundary of that. So I'll just click, and noting that whatever I'm going to bend this page, I will add a new point. So I know that when I'm holding the page from the sides, it will sort of bend in the middle. So I'm going to specify that point, and that one, and I'll continue on throughout. Now on these page bends, I'm going to add more meshes, just to make sure. That one shows probably placed there. One, two, and then end. Just to make sure that meshing is complete. Obviously just moving to my screen here, selecting it again, we can see it created the boundary here. Now these lines, you can call them triangulation lines, which will create a triangle between three points. That's where your image will be adjusted. So what I'm going to do is add a few more. I'm going to say create, and on this I'm going to look at this page. Obviously the edges of this page, I'm not really concerned about it. What I'm concerned about is these corners here, the central points, and then obviously those corners as well. Now noting that when you don't see a line like that, it will probably distort that line work a bit later once you start moving the meshes around. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to add opposite ends here, noting that all of my dots will be opposite, just to make sure that I have these lines there, so that when that meshing creates, it doesn't distort the actual. Maybe get away with a few less. I'll check it out a little bit later. Let me just add it in, and then it's done. Same for this one here. Adding it in, I'm just going to speed up a little bit so you don't have to sit through this boring phase here of adding points. Okay, so once these meshes are created, I can actually go ahead and fix this image up, just routing it, making sure that it fits in the middle of that bone there, so that when it actually binds that bone, it will be in the center of that page. Now what we're going to do additionally, it's going to add some more bones. Now I'm going to add just a click, I'm not going to go too much detail, select my page again, and add those clicks there, sort of in the middle. You can see it's already sort of distorted there. I'll fix it up just now, just placing them in. Okay, let's just fix this image up here with these little dots here. That is my actual meshing object. So obviously, oops, not moving that, just moving the mesh. You can see I can actually manipulate my image quite easily. That one should be, oh, I closed it accidentally. That should be fine. So as I'm editing this, notice what happens to the lines there. This one's gonna be behind, yeah, somewhere. Well, there we are. Okay, so now we're ready to actually bind this. Now, once I select my image and I go to back to my properties, notice that once your mesh is complete, you'll have this edit weights option. Now, the weights is on these particular dots itself. Now, we're not going to get it to the weights in this particular video. I'll go to the weights in the next video, just to explain it a bit more in depth, because all the videos that I've seen, they quickly just up it and down it and change it and swap it, and they don't really explain what the benefits of that is. Maybe on the actual Dragon Bones alpha, so you can find some information on there, but I had no luck on that. So we'll get to that in the next video, which is going to be tutorial 4. It's maybe going to be a little bit shorter, 2 to 4 minutes, not really sure, but we'll check it out. Okay, so once I go back and say edit weights, edit weights, you actually open up a second panel or second option there, which is bone and weight specifically. So if I selected the command, the only one that's actually active in the panel at the moment, bind will allow me to select bones to bind to the actual physical image. So I'm going to select these bones as I go along. Obviously speeding this up again for you guys. In no particular order. Okay, so that wasn't selected in any particular order. Once I'm done, I'm just going to select the tool there, or select tool, any tool really, doesn't matter, and it's going to bind these images. So once I select that bone, and I move it, it actually adjusts my image. Now I can obviously select a few more at once chance. I'm just going to do multi-selector by holding my left click, holding control, deselecting that, and then moving it south. Now you're going to see some distortion along the lines there. Obviously quite visible what distortion actually is. But if you want to fix that up, obviously you've got to go back to your actual nodes. So I'm going to move that out, try and fix this up as quickly as possible. Now this is a very time consuming process, especially if you have a lot of, nodes created on a specific image. Just fixing that up there, selecting that one, dragging it out, selecting this edge, moving it up. You can see it looks a little bit better already. Just moving, maybe just move it out a little bit. A bit more. And then fixing up the rest. Now I'm not going to do the entire image. I'm going to move over to the next one, which I've created earlier, which is called a whip. Yes, I've modeled the whip in here, and it actually came out quite nicely, especially on the animation. I won't be showing you the animation itself. I will show you exported of the animation, a little video snippet, maybe just a few seconds. You can see how it actually works. And there we go. Now my image has been modified. Now these are normal bones, so you can actually add it in the animation slides itself. They call it your animation view. I can't remember the exact terms they use. I think it was timeline. Yeah, it's timeline. So you can apply it in your timeline and move this incrementally along your time slots. Now, hopefully, after we're done with the next tutorial video, and we'll be looking at IK constraints, which is quite useful, especially for arm movements, controlling ligaments with one point specifically. After that, maybe we'll get to animation, but we'll see if we fit it in. Okay, thank you for viewing this video. If you liked it, please hit the like button and subscribe if you want to see more.